Hey guys, Kyle Bascombe here. Today we're going to be replacing the fuel level sender on a 2007 C230 Mercedes, otherwise known as the W203 chassis. The procedure that we show you today is also going to be applicable to some CLK models and C-Class models that have the partial zero emissions vehicle code, which is option code 929. So in order to perform this procedure, we have an OE fuel level sender assembly, which also includes the fuel filter and fuel pressure regulator. And we have the replacement lock rings, as well as the clamp for the lock ring. And what's special about the partial zero emissions vehicles is that they don't use a traditional style lock ring, and you don't need a special tool. It's just held in by this clamp. In addition, we do recommend that you replace the seal, because what tends to happen when you remove the seal from the level sender or from the fuel pump is that it expands, and then when you go to put it back in, it won't seal properly. Now, if you decide that you're going to also be replacing your fuel pump, you might find this video very helpful, because we're also going to go in and remove the fuel pump assembly. So the reason why we're replacing this fuel level sender is not because it's not operating correctly. The level sender is actually made out of plastic, this top portion, and it actually cracked and it's starting to weep fuel vapor. Obviously, you smell it. This particular car has EVAP emissions codes. And what we also found quite funny is that a repair was attempted with an epoxy, like a JB weld or something like that. That's not what you want to be doing in these situations, guys. If this is leaking fuel vapor, just replace the entire assembly. That's what we recommend. All right, so what do you need to replace the fuel pump on a W203 in terms of tools? If you don't have a PZEV vehicle like the one that we worked on today, you are gonna need a special lock ring removal tool. We'll leave a link to this tool in the description. This one's made by CTA. You're going to need various sockets. In our case, we used a 7 mil, 8 mil, 10 and 13 millimeter set of sockets, a 3-inch extension, just to make access a little bit easier, a 1/4-inch and 3/8 drive ratchets, a flathead screwdriver, a pair of snips, and you always wanna have a good light. All right, let's jump right in. To get started, there are 4 13 millimeter nuts that are retaining the seat. There are cosmetic clips that typically sit in front of each position. Unfortunately, this car is missing them, but they just clip in, they pull right out. 13 millimeter. All right, now we're just gonna pull up on the seat and pull it out. So what we're looking at here are the access covers for, on this side is your fuel pump. It's always gonna be your fuel pump on this side. And this is your, we'll call it your transfer pump, level sender assembly, and filter assemblies in here. Level sender assembly, filter assembly, regulator assembly, all in one, is in this unit. Because this car is PZEV, when I pull these access covers off, you'll see there's a harness that plugs directly into the fuel pump. If it's not a PZEV model, that won't be the case. Your harness will only be on this side. These are 8 millimeter fasteners. I'm just gonna start here, removing them. There are normally 6 of these. For some reason, one's missing, and this one didn't feel like it's threaded in anymore. Doesn't feel like it's threaded in, so. A lot of tampering on this vehicle, we've noticed. Just gonna lift that out. So what we're looking at here is the assembly we're going to be replacing. What you'll notice is we've got that epoxy that I referred to in the beginning of the video all over the place here to try to seal up the cracking in the plastic. This is your tank pressure sensor. So if you're setting EVAP codes, this guy's sensing that the tank is losing pressure and that there's a leak. This is your harness to provide power to your fuel pump as well as your level sender assembly. And then this is your fuel hose. We'll be removing all of that. On the other side, we're gonna remove next. There are also 8 millimeter fasteners and it removes the same way. And this is your fuel pump assembly. Like I mentioned on a PZEV car, you'll have a harness and it will be providing power to the pump. A car with no PZEV, it's very likely you're just going to have this assembly minus this harness. What I'm going to do next is relieve the fuel pressure from the system. The way I'm going to do that is by unplugging the power to the fuel pump and starting the vehicle. So we'll do that now. Just gonna let it run until it shuts off. There we go. Right now I'm unplugging the harnesses for the tank pressure sensor and this harness for the level sender. I know I said it provides power for the fuel pump. That's incorrect. these are gonna be for your level sensors. All right, so to remove the locking ring, this is a 7mm fastener. We are working around the fuel tank, so fuel vapors can combust. So just be super careful and no smoking. Another thing you wanna be mindful of is before you start the job, make sure that you're dealing with less than a quarter tank of gas, preferably like an eighth of a tank or less. All right, so I just grabbed the thin screwdriver so I can get behind the clamp and loosen it up a little bit more. There we are. All right, there we are. The clamp is out. Now I'm going to expand this so I can lift it up. There we are. Okay. That's our tank seal. And this is our pump assembly. As you can see here, there's quite a bit of fuel left in the bowl, so we're just gonna be careful and try to dump that out. And then we are going to disconnect where we have the transfer pump connected to the fuel pump line. All right, so there's a 2-pin connector on the hat that I'm going to disconnect. I'm gonna remove the hat. One of the transfer hoses clips into the basket. I'm going to disconnect it. As you can see, that fuel squirted around a little bit. So just be mindful of that. I have a rag nearby, so if I need to wipe up any fuel that's sloshed anywhere or spilled anywhere, I can. Now I'm going to press down on this clamp, and while I'm pressing down, I push the hose in first and then pull it out, and it should release. So pressing down, and there we are. Then we have one more transfer hose that is clipped into the basket, and then we have one harness that we have to unplug. And now we can carefully pull our fuel pump assembly, which also has a level sender arm. We can carefully pull it out of the tank. So I'm just tipping the basket over to try and get as much fuel out of it as I can. Push the transfer lines out of the way. Then we're just gonna come up at an angle and pull that all the way out. I'm going to get a rag under this guy. All right, so now the fuel pump assembly is out. So as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, if you are only replacing the fuel pump assembly, you can stop at this point, put the new unit in, new seal, new lock ring and clamp. However, unfortunately, today we need to remove the level sender assembly on the other side. So we're gonna go over to the other side. It's a very similar procedure, and we'll show you how to do that now. All right, so this is the crazy epoxy side. We don't know what we're going to encounter going in here. We've got the harnesses unplugged, and now I'm pushing it out of the way. We have a clamp for the fuel hose here. We're going to remove that first. I'm gonna grab my rag. Slowly going to remove this hose, anticipating some possible fuel spray. You can see the fuel spilling out a little bit there. There we are, nothing too crazy. Similar to the other side, we're gonna remove the locking ring clamp. On this side, there is a non-standard clamp that's being used. So the other locking clamp is designed with springs to put even pressure on the locking ring. This just seems to be whatever was lying around a shop that was put on this side. So we have the correct OE rings on the site. That's definitely what we would recommend you use. There we are. All right, so similar to the other side, I'm going to expand the ring and then walk it up and out. All right, so I'm gonna wedge out the level sender assembly now. This is a saddle tank, so unfortunately there's an entire hose assembly that's snaked towards the front of the tank, and we're gonna have to fish everything out. Right now, I'm just breaking that seal. So now that that's out, we'll show you how to put the, how to snake the new level sender assembly in. So I've slipped the seal over the new level sender assembly. I have zip tied this end just to kind of keep things together. And now I'm gonna work to snake this assembly to the other side of the tank. And I'm following the very forward section of the fuel tank. So the first thing you'll notice is the lines already tried to go downward, and they weren't going into this, we'll call it the service section or the transfer section. Now they're cooperating. Just being careful to slide the float in. All right, that's kind of tacked in. Now I'm going to go to the other side and kind of align things the way I want it, and then I'll set the level sender assembly in. All right, so I'm just trying to orient things.
Buy your things.
Trying to orient things on this side of the tank here, and turn this assembly to mimic the way that it was prior. Just make sure nothing's binding. All right, so my transfer hose assembly is all the way over. I'll be able to reconnect everything to the fuel pump with no issues. Now I'm gonna go back to the other side and set the level sender assembly in place. And the zip tie that I used to keep everything together, I'm just gonna snip it off now. There we are. I've slipped the seal off this assembly so that it's flush with the opening here. Now we're going to get everything aligned and slip the fuel hose on. So I'm going to turn it towards the hose. And now I'm setting it down in the tank. So now that this is in, I'm gonna put the locking ring and the clamp in, and then we'll put the fuel hose on. So before I put this clamp on, I'm just gonna give it a couple of cranks to make it a little bit smaller. That'll make it easier for me when I'm working in that tighter area there. And that's a 7mm. All right, so now that I found the spot where it's easiest for me to use the tool to tighten the clamp. All right, so now that that's nice and tight, we'll get the clamp and then we'll put this hose back on. Gotta get the flathead for that one. All right, and then once I've got the fuel pump assembly in, we'll worry about reconnecting the electrical connectors. So this is our old fuel pump. Just gonna shove it right back in the service entrance here. Now that it's in, we're gonna clamp our electrical connector as well as our hoses back in. This is the connector. Two-pin connector can only go in one way. I'm gonna do that first. Just make sure you hear it or feel it click in place. Next thing I'm looking for is, there we go, this guy here. I'm gonna clip it into the basket. Then I need the black hose to clip into the basket. There it is. All right, black hose is in. And then lastly, the one that clicks into place. There we are. You heard that click in. That's what you want to hear. All right, now we are just going to get the hat back on. I've got the hat here, as you can see. I've cleaned it up a little bit. No need for it to go back in dirty. I've got our seal for the opening. Just setting that in place. As you'll notice, the seal for the pump side on these PZEV vehicles is different from the seal on the sender side. Now I'm looking for my alignment pins to plug my electrical connector back in. I hope you can see that there. And now I'm just trying to get everything aligned, the hat to the two holes in the pump, so that I can slip that back down. Now that everything's back in, we can walk our locking clamp back in place. There we are. Now that's snapped in correctly, we'll slip our ring on. Similar to the other side, I'm looking for where I'm gonna have good access with my tool and get the clamp butted up right here. Then I'm gonna tighten it until it's about the width of my index finger. All right, that's right about where I need it to be. Remove my socket and twist the tool out. And that's kind of what I had to do to get it in. Put the head of my tool in first and then connect the socket to it. All right, now that everything's in, we're going to reconnect our electrical connectors, turn the key to pressurize the system, check for leaks of that hose, and see if the car starts. It's for my tank pressure sensor. These are replaceable separately if you do run into issues with them. Then our harness for our level senders. Okay, so you can hear the system pressurizing. I'm gonna start the car and see if we have any leaks. Clutch in, neutral. Okay, just in here with a really bright light, checking for any leaks. I don't see any. I'm gonna go test drive the vehicle next, and if everything is good, put the access panels back in, as well as the rear seat. Okay, so test drove the vehicle, no leaks. Now it's time to put the access covers and the seat back in. So we're looking for where the harness has to snake in. That's that hump right here, and that's what we're lining it up with. Feed these fasteners in by hand first, not with a tool. All right, we're gonna go to the other side, do the same thing. All right, so this side doesn't have your hump for the harness because you don't have as thick of a wire gauge as you do for the fuel pump. However, our witness mark is this foam for where the harness is snaking in. So we're just gonna line that up. All right, last thing we need to do is throw the seat back in this vehicle. All right, so for the seat, you are going to want to be mindful of the belt buckle locations and just make sure to get those in the correct slots. And then slide that all the way back. And then you're gonna line it up with the threads over here. Shove that in really good. That thread's in, that one's in. Once everything's lined up, I'm just similar to all these other fasteners, just tacking it in by hand first, and then I'll snug it down with the tool. This one is a 13 millimeter nut. All right, and as I mentioned, normally you will have a cosmetic cover over each of the fasteners. Unfortunately, there's only one remaining on this vehicle. It is a 13-year-old car, so sometimes these things happen. I'll just put this one back. Right in there. And normally there's gonna be an audible click when it goes in place, but the tabs are kind of marred, kind of damaged. So in this case, you didn't hear it. All right, there you have it. So you can see replacing the level sender assembly or the fuel pump on one of these W203 models is not that difficult of a job. If you like what you've seen today, be sure to hit the like button. If you have any questions at all, be sure to leave them in the comments below. And thanks for watching.